Good afternoon. My name is Lester Armstead. I'm the manager for accounting and finance with the Laborers Health and Safety Fund of North America, located in Washington, D.C., at the Laborers International Union of North America's headquarter office. I want to talk to you today a little bit about my experience in 2021 with COVID-19. On January 2nd, I received a call from the Department of Health and Human Services, and I tested positive for COVID-19. And afterwards, we don't remember anything after that point. So I had to lean to my wife to get everything else. And the only thing I do remember is waiting to my wife in the back of the ambulance. And when I got to the hospital, my GFR percentage, which is your total kidney functionality, mine's dropped down to 9% when it should be 60% and above. They had to immediately put me onto a portable dialysis machine in order to save me. I was suffering from what's called acute kidney injury. And afterwards, they had to intubate me because I was in distress with breathing. I was having respiratory failure. And they put the tube into me, and that was in me for 8 days, and they removed it on January 25th. After that, I started to receive multiple hours of physical therapy, occupational therapy, and speech therapy. Prior to COVID-19, I was taking exactly about 7 to 8 medications, and now I'm taking about 22 as a result of COVID-19. And I'm also in dialysis on Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday of every week, probably for the rest of my life or until my kidney function numbers come back up, and if not, until I get a transplant. So right now, I'm in the dialysis treatment center on those days, they're taking out the blood and removing any toxins or anything from the blood and putting it back into my body. And it takes you three and a half hours, sometimes 4 hours to get that done, depending upon how much you want to have removed. 3 pounds, 4 pounds, and usually 4 pounds is the limit. Because anything beyond that, you get sick. So I come to you. On top of that, I have this a portable. This is called the Inogen G5. I have to use this for oxygen because I have issues with oxygen now. I wear an oxygen meter around my neck, and this is to test my oxygen level on a daily basis or every hour or so, and to also check my pulse. I have a disease called hypoxia. And it's where my oxygen level doesn't always, it's not always at 95 or above. So it's an alarm on this. So when I take my oxygen, if it goes below 93, an alarm will go off on this. So these are all the massive changes, not to mention I'm on an extremely, extremely strict diet. No phosphorus, no pizza, no oranges, no orange juice. And the list goes on. No wheat products. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. And these are major changes because I had COVID-19. And if you want to avoid this, in some cases, you know, you can, but keep masking up, washing your hands thoroughly with hot water. And if you're comfortable with it, and get the vaccination. Trust me, you're going to be very, very, very pleased that you got the vaccination. I had no side effects except on the first shot. It hurt my arm a little bit for about a day, and that went away. I had the second shot. The first shot we had, my wife and I had it at the dialysis center, and I had the first shot on March the 30th, and then 21 days on April the 20th, we had the second shot. No side effects, no illness, no nothing. And I think that was already because I already had the virus in me. I already had the antibody in me. So it went in, and, you know, I already had gloves up and ready to fight. So I'm asking you, you know, please think long and hard before rejecting the vaccination. You're going to need it. Your loved ones are going to need for you to get it. If not, and you get sick, it can cripple you financially, economically, and it can cause lots of problems with you. So I'm just begging you, to get the vaccination. If you're comfortable with it, get the vaccination. Thank you for your time, and God bless.